on, it just depends on how long I'm eating before I run. This morning we're having
eggs, run?
And today 5 miles. So we do things the old-fashioned way. All right, Marcelo, give me all your money. It's either omelet, scrambled, or over easy, but to keep things easy this morning, we're gonna go scrambled. I like to flip the bacon twice, it gives it nice, like, crisp. Water's free, don't judge. So what's great about these shorts is they have a built-in liner. What sucks about these shorts is they have a built-in liner. I know more than you do. Did I tell you about my friend who bought the 70-200 and Eduardo was able to fix it by just looking at a picture of it? There's been a podcast, I guess, recently where it's like, oh, like, ask guys, like, what's their breakfast ratio is? Sweet to savory. Like, it's 3-2. 3 savory to 2 sweet. Like, you're gonna have orange juice and syrup, that's your sweet stuff, and you have 1, 2, 3, that's your savory stuff. Well, I mean, I don't have orange juice, right?
1 to 3.
3 to 1.
Yeah.
But I have maple syrup, so it kind of is like 3 to 1.5. And yes, you're having maple syrup.
Thanks, Jeff.
On the clouds. My friend Callie has a co-worker who gets hired at Nat Geo. I only wear them when I run, so today is rare that I'm wearing it to where I'm gonna run instead of having a change of shoes. You would wear at like 60 degrees, I'd wear maybe at 40 degrees while running, but like I have to be running. If I stop running,
oh, it's cold.
That's bringing a bunch of friends.
It's cold today.
Literally, and they're like, you need to come with us. And I was like, okay, I've been filmed all day, like, it'll be funny. I'll be complaining the whole time.
Let's dance in style, let's dance for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the skies. Hoping for the best, but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Let us die young, or let us live forever. We don't have the power, but we never say never. Sitting in a sandpit, life is a short trip. The music's for the sad man. Can you imagine when this race is won? Turn our golden faces into the sun. Praising our leaders, we're getting in tune. The music's played by the madman.
Thirty pace at the end.
Yeah.
Those are passes.
Let's walk it off.
Yeah. Southbound.
What's the better way to say it? Like, let's push it, Warren, or let's punch it, Warren?
I usually would say either push.
Let's push it, Warren. RIP to me.
How many tourists are up today?
Too many. It's beef from New Yorkers, New Yorkers alone, and people everywhere but Europe. As long as you're not from Europe, you're okay.
Next intersection.
What are you getting?
Getting a chai.
I think I'm gonna do the same.
Aaron, A-A-R-O-N. Thank you.
We're all set? Oh, okay.
Are y'all filming right now?
No. Self-important bourgeois assholes.
I'll be up to for the rest of the day.
No, we're in there and the guy's like, you can't film in here. It's like, we're in fucking New York City in a coffee shop. I can film anywhere I want. I can do anything I want. This is the other thing. I showed a watch The Sopranos, and I have the opposite take of John on it. I think it's a wonderful look into, like, class in America, into different social standings, into different things, right? But I don't think anything Tony does is right.
You should. Why are you driving an electric Porsche?
It's like, why are you driving an electric Porsche? Oh, you want to show off? You're not even showing off. You're showing off you don't have taste. You want taste? Get a cab. And there's a program like they use when you're filming golf that's, it's like, it reverses the colors and follows the black ball across the white field. Like, if I was just some loser with a phone, I get it. It's the reason I describe it that way. Loser with a phone. Actually, this is kind of the look with the shorts and the hoodie.
Yeah, it looks kind of tight.
You want to hold this for me real quick? What's up, Eduardo? Oh, he did it. He really did it. Is the one where he sampled Iron Man on there? That's pretty decent. It's just not as, like, creamy. Like, there's different layers to the flavor. And, like, milk has a very particular, like, creamy, heavier, like, viscosity to it. And this isn't as viscous as I'd like it to be. You want it to have, like, a nice solid undercurrent. You want the fat to, like, really congeal with the flavor of the cinnamon and the milk and honey. And you want it to just be, and it's, there's, like, a disconnect. It's kind of separate. It's not that I think they didn't use regular milk. I think they had disdain for us using regular milk. Aaron, I'll check the hours on the place. And his I was a warlock. My god was Anubis. And my character was Ptolemy Eruditus. Look at Alfred.
What train are we taking?
This one. This is my subway station. Clearly, it is outdoors. Every morning, watch out. I look up and figure out which places are painted and which are not. It's all the same every day. Every morning, I go right here. And the door is right here. So if I get onto this door, I walk across. If I take the key to the 14th Street in the R, I get on the door right there. I'm at the emergency exit. Boom, out to 22nd Street. Done. Never lost the B train.
You shut up.
If I'm on the B train, it's better to be on at the center because the F train exit at 23rd is in the center, but it's always more crowded, so I just get on right here. It's just easier. I like to get on the second door from the first car because you get off immediately right there. That way you can get immediately out of the station without having to be behind any people who are slow or don't know where they are or...
European.
The bus driver just went like that. The first time I came to this neighborhood, when I toured the apartment, got out right here, went to the park, waited because I was early. The grocery store right behind you. Really good grocery store. That bike store has been here about as long as I have. Good people have not had to buy a bike. B48, that's the bus I take most frequently back from my club. Depending on the time of day, anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour to get to Greenpoint. So you know what? Still more consistent than the G train somehow. Thriftway, very useful. I respect their hours, but they're only open when I'm not there. Like, I can't just go before work, and I can't just go after work, because it's not open enough time on either end to be like, oh, there's enough time. Across the street is that Hallie?
Hi!
Sorry to interrupt you. They're following me around and filming me all day. It's very funny.
Who's on the corner? Because I was making eye contact with him. Is that you or somebody else?
Sorry to interrupt your conversation.
No. It's so good to see you. I'm Hallie, by the way.
Hey, I'm Zach.
Nice to meet you.
They're filming me all day.
This is the day that you... Yeah. I don't know why I thought that was Sunday. And I was like, well, we can say no to that. So we'll see what happens with that.
Well, that see you.
Money. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoy your bagels. Yep. Have a good day.
See you tomorrow.
See
you. Yes, yeah, let me... Just text me.
Funny. Yeah, sometimes I run into people. The last time I ran into somebody was a photographer who's like relatively well known. But I didn't say anything because I was sweaty. See what's up? Does he know?
I'm being serious. Does he know what you want?
The first time I moved, well, when I moved in the second week with my dad and all the furniture, I got stuck in the elevator. Fire department had to come and get us. Now, of course, I didn't know that, like, the door will just partially open. You just need to, like, get it shut and either hit one or hit the floor you're going to, and that'll, like, fix it, but not really. The problem is there's a lot of old people in the building, and they can't just do that. They're not as dumb as I am. They're not dumb whatsoever. I'm dumb.
It's a nice elevator.
Oh, it is.
What's that, a speaker? Looks like a speaker.
It's the window there. Come on, we did it, boys. Nice, really nice. Haven't met. Really nice. Light.
Any bad ones?
No, not on this floor.
Other floors?
I mean, yeah, but no. Really nice. Really nice. Really nice. Really nice. And that was just weird. Somebody, when I was being a stagehand, I was like, oh yeah, like my new apartment, it's kind of a bidet. They're like, what do you want a bidet? Like, what are you putting your ass for? And I'm like, they're like, you know, how does it make you feel? And they're expecting some like homoerotic, like unexpected statement. And I was just like, I don't know, man, I just feel clean. And he was like, oh, you're not gonna talk about the intense pressure? It's like, no, I feel clean.
Like if we had to, I don't know, if someone texted me, oh, I'm doing this thing, and I was like, cool, that'd be interesting. I could get up, change, be out of here in 10 minutes. But nobody's texted me that, so why would I go?
Wait, I matched the girl on Hinge.
Oh, shit.
And I sent the link today. Yeah, she had a life goal of mine. Her words were, hoy vey, and I responded, yeah.
I'm being recorded the whole day. Apparently, I'm interesting. It's like a reverse Truman Show, and I keep doing bits. I don't know if I should send that.
Maybe like a quarter of that. Like the first sentence is good.
I'm being filmed.
Yeah. Exactly. You're not being recorded. This is a film.
You can't film in here. Shut the fuck up.
Honestly, an overrated building. Like, cool, like, we came back, like, we rebuilt it, like, New York is there. New York was going to be there no matter what. I'm not saying, I'm not taking the side of anybody here. More so as someone who had to go to work in that building, the new one, 1WTC. Like, getting there, getting in, being there, every step you take, you're monitored. It's not even like an airport, it's just like, it's spooky. Like an airport, it's like, yeah, you don't yell bomb at an airport. It's a bad idea, because people are kind of expecting that, because it's a way to get, you know, ideals across, unfortunately. And the security's so, you know, full of themselves because they have this legacy to protect. There's 20 years, you know, of history. Okay, cool, there's years of history behind every building. All sorts of buildings are demolished in, you know, alleged terror attacks. And especially it's the attitude, because it comes down to the same, like, psychology of middle managers. It's like, I'm in charge of this building, and you have to deal with that. It's like, cool, you can walk into almost any other building in New York City, and if you've got a backpack, they might ask to search it, as is their right. They should make sure. You never know who you're going to be dealing with. But then, denial based on the specific dimensions or a refusal to understand what's in it or hear out an explanation. It's one thing when it's like, why are you bringing in this black cube that's ticking? Yeah, that makes no sense. Why would you bring that in a building? You're not going to be allowed in. But a light with the power cord and the whole thing, like...
Did you go to the bathroom?
Mm-hmm.
How was your experience in the bathroom?
I give it a solid 5 out of 10. I took a good shit, but not a good shit.
Why do you think the security is so bad?
I have... 2 words for you.
I was at a birthday party in Central Park, like October, and the girl I'm talking about's roommate, as I'm taking the picture, looks me in the eye and bites into a strawberry. And not just like I'm minding my business, but like And I'm like, okay, cool. I'm gonna follow up on this. So over the course of the next month, it's like DMing back and forth until I'm finally like, hey, like we should meet up. She's like, oh yeah, I'm actually entering something serious. And I was like, okay, like thank you for telling me. You know, leave it there. Like there's no hard feelings. Problem is, the second I presented all that information to someone else, pre the message, they're like, well, maybe the roommate. And I'm like, well, I don't know what to tell you, man.
Roommate didn't talk to me, and in fact was annoyed that I stopped her to get her Instagram, like, of the roommate. Like, I don't know. Vibes are weird. Vibes are off.
One of the roommates just put on her story. She's free for her dinner break. And I'm like, I can't tell if that's for me. I doubt it. She's got 750 followers on her main story. Like, it's like it's a casting a wide net there. I'm just saying. I don't know who that's intended for. I don't think it's for me.
What does that mean?
I have no idea. That's why I'm like,
what does it say?
If anyone wants to get wine on my dinner break by the theater, I am free 4 to 5:30. This is not a drill. Swipe up if you're real. Like, communication.
When's the last time you spoke?
October. Like, I have not talked to her. I have talked to her roommate. And that last time I talked to her was November. I think there's no pretext here.
No, there's no pretext.
I also think there's no text here.
No, there's not even, like, subtext.
Listen, if I have to go back to Manhattan...
How will I have time to watch The Sopranos tonight?
No, I meant it's awkward to see, like, just, you know, be filmed.
Filmed by three different cameras.
Is it strange? Is it uncomfortable?
It's a little strange. It is nice to have, like, that urge to perform. Where it's like, cool, like, I'm going to sit there and I'm going to say some more than normal. I'll just release the internal monologue, but... Well, normally it's either under my breath or to myself or to a individual colleague, as opposed to recorded in perpetuity. Which is fine. Like, everybody knows my opinions. And if they don't, they don't know me. Am I wrong? Oh, I should win the lottery. And by that, I mean a scratch-off so I can pay for a tattoo from Ink to NYC. I would only do it because there's the connection there. That's really it. Like, if he didn't come in, I would be like, I'm never going there. That's how I am about most things, so. Like, I don't go to Grabstein's by work because I don't know them. I don't trust them. I go to Chick-fil-A because I know them. I trust them. Occasionally I go to McDonald's. I don't know them, but I do trust them. Or I go to Ricky. I trust Ricky. He doesn't know me, but I trust Ricky. He might kill Marcel one day.
What at?
Your name tag?
Oh, yeah. Aaron Kassman. I work at Rentals at Fotocare.
Like, just imagine if I walked into the street. When the sunlight hit the water. It's like, honestly, like, you pass for, like, under this arch, suddenly you're just in the park. Like, you'll still hear the siren,
but you're more deep in the park.
Well, not even, it's just like it becomes, who's that guy following us? Another thing I don't like, buskers. It's like, I get it, you're a musician. What if I had music in? What if I wanted to listen to that? Quite a few times I've like run through here and there's just like a wedding or a celebration happening and there's nothing more beautiful than you get free live music and other people who have to like be dressed up for an event and you're just over here all sweaty and just like but it's very pretty. It was frozen over like a week ago.
You know, there's been a heap of legends and tall tales about Robin Hood, all different too. Well, we folks of the animal kingdom have our own version. It's the story of what really happened in Sherwood Forest.
Right here is where I started reading Crime and Punishment, March 18th, last year. I get 10 pages in, I'm like, wow, this is really good. This is really easy to read. I don't know what people have been talking about, complaining about the whole time.
No, actually, no, I have my office.
Also, it's a really nice view.
It's really not that complicated. You just look at me, you got a picture. If it were easy, anybody could do it.
Yeah. They make a film about a photographer. I'm like, I want it to be still. Stop making it moving.
Oh, no, it'll crazy. Be
okay. Can you take a picture for me of them taking taking their thingy?
I got you.
I go to Vienna on the 21st till the 28th. I've been there 36 times.
What is it you do?
I'm a performer.
Yeah? What kind of performance?
I dance my ass off.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like nobody's ever seen before.
I bet you're good at it.
Yeah. I, what?
What's your name?
Bravo.
Bravo.
Yeah.
Dope ass. Nice to meet
you. What? Where you at? He's still, he's at it. Where you at? You got them all? No. I think we should do film or something. Oh, that's close up. Guys are nuts. What, don't, you don't move or he's Mr. Zoom over here.
Mr. Zoom.
I was wondering, I told him, what's with the antenna? Oh, it's not an antenna. Yeah, see, this is the thing. When everybody stop. Oh, what's going on? Nothing. What would you do? Did you shoot him?
No, okay.
Come on, man. I'm doing the 92nd Street Y Tuesday and Wednesday for kids. But we're going to work it out. From this point on, it's on.
It's different, yeah.
There we go.
You gonna send it to me?
Yeah,
it's the 6x6. I never even heard that before. 6x6. Well, I'm doing 6x6. I'm like, yeah, okay, come on.
Yeah.
Tomorrow I'm gonna be like, we're doing 6x6. Everybody's gonna be what? I'm like, I don't know. If we can't do 6x6, I gotta make a phone call.
This is what happens when I take my headphones off.
I'm gonna hold your.
Nope. I got a whole system.
These are already. Super Bowl tomorrow.
Yep. Should be fun.
What team do you support?
Honestly, I don't really like either.
Can I get on camera?
Oh, yeah, you're good. Sorry.
No, I want to get on camera.
Oh, you want to?
Yeah. It's a video. It's a video?
Yeah.
What's up? How's everyone doing? Is it going on YouTube?
Have a wonderful evening.
You too, and have a good day tomorrow.
Thank you. And good luck.
Following us all day.
Who the fuck is this guy?
Who are you?
What are you suring me for? I didn't stutter.
You gonna...
Wait.
Yeah.
Oh, was I supposed to put the door open for you?
Les rêves des amoureux sont comme le bon vin. Ils donnent de la joie ou bien du chagrin. Affaibli par la faim, je suis malheureux. Pas longtemps chemin, tout ça.
Me and my pre-opened bottle of wine that I opened about 10 minutes ago. Take a little smell. Solid palate. Notes of, mostly like, kind of like blueberry, maybe like raspberry-ish. There's also a nice sweet on the top. Very, very tart through the middle and very almost like carbonated, but not carbonated. It has a nice tingle to it. To the beginning of hopefully a series of projects that will not involve me.
Cheers.
Right. You gotta tap glasses with me. You're not gonna fucking do that to me.
start spreading. I'd be them today. I thought of be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city
you didn't have
that doesn't sleep.